Hi, everybody. It's Mr. Gray here. I just want to thank everyone for another great week of school. We're already kind of past the 30th day of school now, which is 1/6 of the way through the year, which is really incredible. It's going so fast, but we're into October now. And so I just have a few announcements first. The first thing is next week. So next week is the official conference week, even though I've already kind of started some of them. And so October 4th through 8th is kind of a crazy week. There is no school at all on Tuesday, October 5th, and then all the other days are minimum days. So the kids get out at 1:40 on Monday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. And of course, I'll see many of you for conferences next week via Zoom. The link is on the updates page, and I think it's on the place that you signed up. So all that's happening next week, including Picture Day on Wednesday. So Picture Day is Wednesday, October 6th. And I can tell you that our Picture Day is going to be in between recess and lunch. So, we'll try to remind the kids that day to maybe not get too sweaty after recess, but we'll come back and have a little chance to cool down, I think, before we actually do Picture Day. And the final announcement is an announcement going forward in the future. And that's on Friday, October 15th. We're going to have a little movie and stuffed animal party just in the afternoon. We'll just watch a movie together, and the kids can bring stuffed animals they want to, if they want to just like kind of hang out during that afternoon. And that's just a celebration for all the hard work that we've done so far. The kids come here and work hard every day, and so we deserve to have a little fun for that. So that's coming up Friday, October 15th. The movie is to be announced. Mrs. Farley and I will kind of talk about it and figure it out. That's what's going on that day. Okay, on to academics. For Reader's Workshop over the next couple weeks, we're finishing up our first fiction unit. We're really bouncing back and forth between fiction and nonfiction throughout the year to keep it fresh, and also because those are both kind of important different kinds of reading. And so we're going to finish up our first fiction unit, and we're going to, at the end, really be talking about figuring out words in different ways. So just at the end of this week, currently, we were talking about chunking words. If I find a word that I don't know, like handkerchief, which was in one of our reading, I can't just skip that word if I don't know it. I might not know the meaning, but I need to try to read it. And sometimes that will give me some clues. And then we'll also go into figuring out words based on context clues, and we'll have some practice. And then we'll also discuss figurative language. And that's all to kind of get students, on the path of like discovering new words and understand the meaning of words that they haven't tackled before, so they can tackle harder texts. And then at the end of next week, we'll start a book report. I'm still putting that together, but they'll choose one of the books they have read or are reading and do some work related to what we've been studying. So that's what's happening in Reader's Workshop. And then, a little bit more in the future, we're going to switch to nonfiction for a little bit. In Writer's Workshop, the kids are on their third published piece. They're going to publish their third piece maybe at the end of next week or the week after. And in this last kind of section of our narrative writing unit before we switch to opinion, we're really looking at the students to what we call be their own job captain. So it's not as much in this last little part for me to do all the teaching. They're going to have kind of a checklist of the things that we've gone over. And the expectation is they're using that checklist. They're using their previous published pieces. They're using mentor texts. They're using the charts on the wall. They're using the tools I've given them to write another piece. And then in a little more advanced way for students who are ready, they might not just be writing a narrative true story. They might be writing a narrative true story that has like a problem and a solution. They might focus on a time where there were really strong emotions involved. And so for students that are writing, that's a way to kind of like lift the level of their writing in this last part. And then along with moving from fiction to nonfiction reading, we'll be moving from narrative to information writing. And those fiction books and the information writing, or I'm sorry, the nonfiction books and the information writing will go kind of hand in hand over the next few weeks. In math, we are getting into multiplication, I think I mentioned last week. And so this week and next week, we're really laying the foundation of what multiplication is. We want students to have a strong conceptual understanding of multiplication for the times where they don't know or can't remember a certain math fact. And so like you can imagine that like twos and fours and fives and tens are often the things that we'll start with. And they're also the easy ones because we kind of see those in the real world. You know, we're very familiar with fours because we see four cars all over the place and we can understand groups of fours. You know, we don't often see groups of sevens in places or groups of sixes or groups of nines. So as we get into like the more difficult math facts, we want kids to have this like very strong understanding of how I can figure out if I don't remember it. And so the way we're doing that at the start is we're looking at subitizing dots, which is we're looking at patterns of dots. You can imagine it's like the same kind of patterns that are on playing cards. And so I can see like groups, I can like group together in my mind dots and I will see patterns. And that will help me put together groups of things. So you can imagine that if I have four groups of four, the first way we display that is four little dots in a square with a big circle around it. That's one group of four. So if I had four groups of four, I just have that repeated four times. And so we're looking at dots in groups. So we're talking about groups of numbers. We're also practicing counting on a hundreds chart in different ways. We're counting up by fours, we're counting down by fours, and we're looking at the pattern. We'll move from there into arrays, which is like those same dots, but organized in a rectangle. So four groups of four would be four rows of four dots. So there's one row of four dots and then another on top and another on top and another on top. So that's like how we would go into next week. And then we're gonna turn those into factor trees. And that will lead us into math facts and the area of a rectangle. And so that's gonna take us quite a while. And so we're gonna do that for multiplication, go back to the foundations of division after we do that. And then that should take us all the way up to winter break. And honestly, we'll still be reviewing that throughout the whole year. So there'll be small little assessments that I'm using with the whole class and with individuals to kind of see how well you know math facts. And then we'll have all sorts of practice related to that as we go. In social studies next week, I'm not sure if we're going to move on to our next chapter yet because it's such a short week. I'm not sure where we're going to have time, if at all. So possibly no social studies next week. And then science, we're going to try to finish up our pet umbrellas and the presentations that go along with those. And again, it's a short week, so we don't have a lot of time for science. If we move on, we'll be moving on to different forces. And we'll be starting with like looking at our class playground and seeing the forces that are involved in swings and tether balls and the slide and all sorts of things. So that's what's going on. As always, if you have any questions, comments, concerns, you know, send me an email or stop by. I look forward to seeing you all at conferences. And if you have any questions about that or something you want to discuss, you can always tell me ahead of time. Okay. Have a great weekend. I know it's going to be a little bit of a crazy week because of the change of schedule. And then even the next week after that, the following week, Monday, October 11th is a no school day. All the teachers are at school doing a staff development. So it's a little bit of craziness for the next couple of weeks, but then we'll get right back into the swing of things. All right. That's all for me. Have a great weekend. Bye-bye.